to Elite Golf Coaches Tip of the Month. This month we're looking at the importance of the width in the golf swing. Okay, so what we're going to try to feel today is when we hit the golf ball, the key to getting consistency and also getting distance is not necessarily how hard you hit it, but it's how wide the golf swing is. Okay, so what we're going to try to feel when we're going to hit these shots is that we're creating this big circle in the golf swing. That's one of the key elements of creating the power. If you watch the players that hit the ball the longest way, they tend to create a wider backswing, back and through. Okay, so they keep the circle of the swing feeling like a big motion. Okay, so what I want you to try to feel when you hit these shots today is we're going to work on getting the club to be wide and away from our body. So we're really feeling that left arm and club and shaft working together. So I'm just going to show you a couple little drills to help you try to create that width in the backswing. So when you take your setup here, we're trying to feel that setup. Left arm is comfortably straight. The shaft is almost in line with my arm, but it's always a slight angle. It's never dead straight with this. It's always a slight angle because of the way the grip is. But pretty much it's feeling almost in line. Nice and relaxed. Right elbow's got a little bit of flex in it here. Okay, so that's very important. When I take my setup, the right elbow is just flexing, almost pointing down towards my right hip slightly. The key from here is the shoulders are going to create the width in the swing. So when you take that club back, you're going to focus on that club staying low to the ground for the first sort of 6 to 10 inches, really sweeping the grass on the way back with the club head and doing it by using the shoulders. So as I take the club back, I'm really feeling the shoulders pushing the club back wide. So at waist height, the left arm is still straight, comfortably straight, and the club is running on the same line as my toes. So if I just show you this, feeling here, pushing back my left arm. So when I go back to waist height, the club is still pointing almost the same position. So if I was to turn to face the golf club and drop it down, it would be exactly where I was when I started my setup. So I'll just show you that again. So here, pushing back very wide with my left arm, creating the width, turning to face it, dropping down, and it's exactly the same as what it was. The key point is I'm not trying to feel hands in the shot. I'm not trying to get too handsy in the motion. I'm really feeling my shoulders creating the width in the backswing. So I'll just show you this swing now. So from here, I'm going to take my left arm, extending the club back nice and wide to waist height. I continue to turn, so I'm keeping the club wide and away from me. I'm not hinging it and creating a little circle. I'm creating a big circle as I swing back. So from here, taking it back, pushing it back wide, and swinging through. So I'm really feeling here as I hit the shot that I'm creating width. Just one more time, left arm extending the club back, big circle, and swinging through. So as I'm hitting the shot, I'm always trying to keep that width in the backswing. So when you do the practice there this week, with all the clubs, drivers, five woods, five irons, everything you're hitting, you're trying to feel the width. And the key is the left arm and the shaft and the wrist all moving as one, and the shoulders are creating that movement. So my wrists are passive, I'm pushing back my shoulders, and I'm creating that wide takeaway. Have a go at that when you go to the practice area this week, and I think you see a big difference in your consistency, but also the extra distance you'll create with that wider swing.